Two balls and a strike to count on Taylor. Reyes fires. Swing and a drive. Deep left field. This is way back. Walk him off. Chris Taylor.
What's up, everybody? Welcome into Dodger Heads, presented by DodgerBlue.com. My name is Jeff Spiegel, joined today by DodgerBlue.com's Blake Williams. And kind of a busy Friday in the baseball world. Lots of random stuff happening right as the winter meetings are about to get underway. Blake, I wasn't expecting early December, late November to be as busy as it has been.
Yeah, it was pretty shocking. I was surprised, especially with like the big quality of signings, not just little signings here and there. So it was a surprising day for sure.
Yeah, the headlines, three moves that I would say as it relates to the Dodgers. The first is Jacob deGrom signs a massive contract with the Rangers. Chris Martin, a guy who finished the season with the Dodgers, gets a big deal, 2 years with the Red Sox. And then Colton Wong, a guy that we just recorded a video that Ken Rosenthal was saying the Dodgers were interested. He ends up getting traded to Seattle. So Blake, I'll let you decide which of these three moves from a Dodgers perspective do you find to be the most interesting?
Probably the DeGrom one, because they were in on the top of the market free agent starters and he just kind of set the market at, he got 5 years, 185. That's nearly 40 million a year. I think it comes to 37. So that's going to kind of affect their pursuit of Verlander, especially if the Mets turn to Verlander to try and replace DeGrom. So that's probably going to affect them the most. Obviously, the Chris Martin move is significant because he was with the team and they're losing a key reliever, but they've shown they can replace relievers and build a good bullpen no matter what.
The DeGrom contract is insane to me. Five years, 185 with like a sixth year that we don't totally understand that could take it to 222. I mean, for a guy that has missed as much time, I said that I would feel as good about Verlander for 2.5 years as I would DeGrom. DeGrom gets five.
Yeah, they kind of had to overpay. They won, what, less than 70 games last year, so...
That's their MO.
Yeah, they were in a tough spot. They needed pitching. We all know they were trying for Kershaw for 2 years, didn't get him. So they kind of had to go get someone. It's a lot for DeGrom, but like Friedman has said before in free agency, if you're rational, you're going to miss out on guys. So you got to be kind of crazy sometimes.
Yeah, well, they were crazy. They have been historically crazy. They have not turned crazy money into any semblance of competitive baseball, but maybe next year things are different. Chris Martin is the most interesting. This is a guy that I really wanted back with the Dodgers. I thought he was very good. I thought he fit the profile. I thought he was pretty much everything you want in a relief pitcher, as well as a guy that I just felt confident could replicate what we saw. 2 years, $17.5 million, I believe, was the contract he signs with the Red Sox. That's a lot of money. I wouldn't have hated it if the Dodgers gave him that deal, but I also understand why, if that's the money that Martin comes to the Dodgers with, I understand why the Dodgers say no thanks.
Yeah, they weren't going near that deal. He would have essentially been a fourth or fifth reliever in their bullpen, if not lower on the depth chart. So paying him nearly $9 million a year for that, it just wasn't going to happen. Maybe if it was 1 year, I could see it happening, but 2 years was pushing it. I mean, they just signed Shelby Miller for 1 year at $1.5 million. That's the kind of moves they're going to make. We're going to see them involved in Alex Reyes. They've already been connected to him. They're going to try and find guys that they can get for cheap and make into good relievers.
Yeah, no, I agree. And then the last move was Colton Wong. And you could kind of tie in a bunch of Brewers stuff here. Again, Ken Rosenthal said the Dodgers were interested in Colton Wong. Matt and I did a video where we both shook our heads and say, this makes no sense to me. You and I talked offline. Colton Wong to the Dodgers never made a much sense. He ends up with the Mariners. And then Willy Adames, a guy that many people have asked about as a potential shortstop candidate via trade. The Brewers have said that he and their pitchers are off limits as it comes to trade. They're going to keep those guys. And so no love lost for me on the Colton Wong move. I was not excited about trading for him. Jesse Winker, I believe, going back. So kind of an interesting major league for major league swap there. Does that even move the needle for you? Or do you just say, yep, that's kind of what I expected. The Dodgers not involved.
Yeah, I didn't really expect that to happen. It didn't really make much sense. They have guys who are similar to Colton Wong, and moving Gavin Lux out of position just didn't really make any sense at all, especially when Lux's best defensive value is his range at second base. And without the shift, that's going to be valuable there. So putting him there at third when he has throwing issues, it's weird.
And look, people were like, why are you even recording this video? I was like, look, if Ken Rosenthal says it, we have to take it seriously, right? This isn't John Heyman saying, well, what if they move Gavin Lux to third? But I'm with you. It's like Gavin Lux's arm was the issue. We're going to move him further away from first base. How does that make any sense? It didn't. And clearly the Dodgers, I mean, who knows? Maybe the Dodgers were interested and they just got outbid. Hard to say now. When I look at these three moves, I don't really see any of these as, oh, now the Dodgers have to pivot. You said, hey, the Dodgers probably in at the top of the market. There have been rumors about that. I was never very excited about Jacob deGrom. I thought that Justin Verlander made more sense because it's not going to be a five-year deal. It's going to be hopefully two if it is the Dodgers, maybe three if it's somebody else. Chris Martin, though, was a guy that I wanted. Colton Wong doesn't move the needle. So do any of these change where the Dodgers go next? You mentioned starting pitching. Like, do the Dodgers need to get more aggressive on Verlander? Do they explore starting pitching via trade? What do you think? How do you think these moves impact Andrew Friedman's offseason?
I don't think it's going to affect him too much. Friedman's the kind of person, he's going to wait for the right move to come to him. Like Freddie Freeman fell into their lap. Mookie fell into their lap. He's not going to go out and overpay for free agents. He didn't overpay for Corey Seager. It's just not what he does. So I think they're going to stay in on Verlander. They're going to look at the trade market. They're going to do whatever they can to find starting pitcher, but they're going to wait for the right deal.
Yeah. No, I agree with you. I mean, there's a lot of headlines here, and it's fun as a Major League Baseball fan, but as a Dodger fan, I kind of look at this and say, DeGrom, okay, I'm so glad that the Dodgers didn't touch that with a 10-foot pole. Chris Martin, dang, I really wanted him back, but like you said, not really interested in paying $9 million a year for Chris Martin. Colton Wong, didn't make any sense. Willy Adames, not my favorite guy at shortstop. And so, all in all, an exciting day in Major League Baseball. I think we both agree, not really moving the needle if you're a Dodger fan. Move along. Lots of guys still out there. Lots of options still around as the winter meetings get underway. You expecting anything big from the Dodgers over the next week or so, Blake?
It depends how quickly the market moves. If the DeGrom market kind of set up Verlander's market, it's a possibility. But baseball signings, they usually take all year to get done. So
yeah,
I'm not expecting it, but it wouldn't shock me if it happens. The Dodgers are just going to keep waiting and waiting until they find the right move. That's what they do. I mean, they're obviously trying to cut payroll, so they're not going to go out spending a ton. It's just, so they could do whatever they want, really. So
yeah, I'm with you. And if they rolled out a lineup that they have today, they would be fine. They won't. Don't worry, everybody. They won't. But if they did, they'd be fine. That's Blake Williams. I'm Jeff Spiegel. As always, thanks for joining us. If you're a podcast person, make sure you subscribe to us. We're part of the Blue Wire Podcast Network. You can find us at Spotify, Apple, Google, wherever you get that. And of course, subscribe, ring the notification bell right here on YouTube for all sorts of content. Trey Turner updates, trade rumors, all that kind of stuff. An off-season roadmap coming up over the weekend. Lots of good stuff. So as always, thank you for joining us. Enjoy the rest of your day. And of course, go Dodgers.